Hello students, in this video lecture we are going to see radial basis functions. Now, as the name suggests, what do you think this is going to be like? Radial basis functions, and it's a very important part in neural networks. As you've seen different nodes, we are basically, all those nodes basically draw a line to divide the data, to divide the cluster, divide the data inputs that we have, divide the different features that we have. It draws a line, or there will be a combination of different nodes. We can have multiple lines to derive the data. So wouldn't it be good, instead of drawing a line, if you could draw a circle, right? Draw a circle. Now what I'm talking about here is that is a kind of a problem. Okay, so I'll just take different color over here. Just going to find, write some one color data points. Okay, these are different data points that you have. Fine. And there are other data points over here of different color, or like this. So with your, what the network that we have seen, what the nodes that we have seen, okay, the nodes that we have seen with your, what is that? With your, the nodes that we have seen in the previous classes, what you have seen, you can basically draw a line. So we require a multiple number of lines over here to divide, right? I'm going to draw this over here, and I'm going to draw a line like this, right? And maybe still there might be some nodes which will still get into it if they're a common value, right? There will be some kind of error also. So this is how you can, you'll be able to divide the data using the nodes that we have seen. Instead of that, if a node was able to draw, instead of drawing a line, what if it was able to draw a circle? Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw a circle over here, which will divide this whole data into different parts. Okay, my circle is not very bad, so there, we got only 3 points inside that. But that's what you get. So only one node will be able to solve the whole problem. That is what I'm saying. So what are the modes of functions that we have seen right now? Most of the nodes that we have seen, okay, most nodes that we have seen, they are what? Non-increasing functions. They are monotonically non-increasing functions. That what we have seen, the kind of nodes that we have seen. Okay. So this is what the problem that we come across. So this can be solved using, using one hidden layer. Using one hidden layer can solve these kind of problems using these kind of neurons. Okay? One hidden layer with feed forward network with sigmoid function. Okay? With feed forward neural network and sigmoid function, we can solve. I think we have done this kind of problem in feed forward networks. Sigmoid functions we also have seen, and using that we can solve this kind of problem. Right? That is your monotonically non-increasing functions that we use, the nodes that we have seen. Although, okay, one node will be sufficient. Okay, if you do this, one node will be sufficient. Something like this. And I just explained. Okay? If, what is that? A function approximates, a circle. Okay, that is what we see. If it approximates circle, it will look like this. Right? So a function is radially, what happens over here? A function is radially symmetric. Radial basis function, what is the definition? I'm just going to tell you the definitions. A function is radially symmetric or radial basis function. Its output depends on the distance. Okay, output depends on distance of input sample, input vector from another vector, another stored vector. Okay, so output of this depends on the distance between this one of the input sample from the other stored vector. So neural network whose node are radially symmetric functions are called as RBF nets, radial basis function nets. So who are called as radial basis function nets? Which are radially symmetric functions. Okay, neural arousal nodes are radially symmetric. That's important over here. Radially symmetric. So when this happens, you will be able to do it with one node itself. Okay. So I'm just going to derive few things over here, or basically write equations for this. So each commonly used RBF, let's say RBF with delta, okay, delta is non-increasing function. Okay, each RBF non-increasing function of distance measure is non-increasing function of distance. So it's based on distance, and what we are going to see, distance measure. And what is the distance measure? Distance measure is u. Okay, distance measure is u. So RBF is going to be a function of distance. Okay, it's going to be denoted as delta u1. This is a distance, first unit distance. It is going to be greater than u2. Now where will this happen? RBF of this function, RBF is greater than u of u1, is greater than another function, whenever the distance is less. So u1 is less than u2. If u1 is less than u2, the RBF function goes. So it is basically inversely proportional, you can say. Okay? So it is the function used applied to Euclidean distance. Function delta is applied to Euclidean distance. Euclidean distance. What is the formula for Euclidean distance? So u should be nothing but a difference between the mean and the input. Right, between the mean and input. So mu is a center or stored vector. Okay, that is your mu, center or stored vector. And I is nothing but your input vector. Right. So u is a distance between the stored and the input. That is what the definition of RBF. That's what we have seen. Right? So vector norms after Euclidean distance may also use. Vector norms other than? Yeah, we have used Euclidean distance over here. You can also use other measures. Other distance measures can be used. There's Bhattacharya distance, there is which is based on probability. There's other Mahanobuli's distance measures also there. Okay? The different vector measures, vector norms can be used instead of Euclidean. So that depends on your application of RBF networks, where you're going to apply. Right? So in RBF networks, the Gaussian is described by the exponential. Now you can also have Gaussian function over here. Delta of Gaussian, if you have a Gaussian function over here, it's going to be directly, you must all remember what is a Gaussian function look like. So it's an exponential of minus u by c, the whole square, right? And it's the most widely used radially symmetric function. Okay, radially symmetric function. That's a Gaussian function, right? Most widely used radially symmetric. Why is Gaussian radially symmetric? In 2D, it looks like this. Okay, but in top direction, if you look at it, it will look like this, right? This is a top view. This is a front view. Okay, and this I'm just saying 2D. In the 3D, it will be like this. Yeah. Pardon my drawing. Yeah. So it's most widely used radially symmetric function. It's your Gaussian radial function, right? So other symmetric function can also be used. One is Hardy's inverse quadratic. You want to write equations. And these are different equations that you can use, by the way. Hardy's inverse quadratic equation. Okay, what is that? It is nothing but delta of u equals c square. It's written 2. Hardy's equation because there is square over here. Based on beta. Okay, for beta less than 0. So beta is the value is less than 0. You have c square plus u square. Okay. Now hyperspheric. You can also have hyperspheric function. This is all very mathematical. Okay, because we are trying to get the best possible solution. Rho of s. Okay, I was saying the function RBF is rho. I was saying I think delta is rho of s. R1, 0. This is rho. If u1 u is less than or equal to c, it's 1. If u is greater than c, right? So it defines a fixed radius which with output is high. So that is a hyperspheric function. It defines a fixed radius within which output node is very high. So basically it is somewhat like this. Okay, it's somewhat like this. So this is your front view and the top view is going to be the view. Oh sorry, it's a radial function. So it's going to be a circle. Yeah, it's a circle. Yeah. So this is your top view. This is your front view. Okay, it's going to be very high inside the circle. So RBF nets are usually used for function approximation problems, especially interpolation. Okay, that application is used for function approximation problems, especially interpolation. Now this is also used to solve, as I told you, let's minimize this. Yes. So what we have seen over here, these are RBF networks and this is your non-increasing function rho, and it can be done using gradient distance, then there are other kind of functions you can use replace with. Okay. So now here it is used to solve corner isolation problem also. What is the corner isolation problem? We had earlier seen something. There is a problem. One node cannot solve. I mean, one node or one node cannot solve this. What is that? Okay, we cannot draw a one line which will divide this into different paths, right? So this can be solved using RBF nodes. So we draw one circle. Okay, I hope this looks like a circle. So this is what we do. So this, what does this network look like? The network is going to look like this. This is the RBF node, how it is denoted. And this is given to your output node. It can have a bias value 1 over here if we require. And the inputs can be given to this. So x, y and the constant bias over here. So this is how it will be. So this is your RBF node. And this is your output. This is how it will solve your radial function. But if you want, if you can also have a multiple RBF node network, okay, the same problem can be solved in this. We'll draw, instead of one node, we have to solve with multiple RBF nodes and we can draw it this way. Okay, and for this, how the network is going to look, now this is going to be our output node. It's going to be our output node and I'm going to draw a multiple of RBF nodes over here. The last one will be 1 and this is your RBF node for each of these circles over here. 1 is this and this, these are the circles, right? Sorry, this one. So and then again there are 3 inputs, x, y and 1. These are inputs which are going to go to all these, sorry, this is not input, right? And then y again will also go to all these RBF nodes. It is also going to all of these nodes. Okay, so that's it. This is how we can solve the corner isolation problem. Thank you so much for your patience.